Another wave of local corporate earnings reports today, starting with PLDT as it nets 9.7 billion pesos in the third quarter, bringing its nine-month income just to 28.1 billion, just up 1%. Excluding the drag from legacy revenues, net service revenues would have grown 5%. The telco giant also expects mid-single-digit growth for the full year and telco core income north of 35 billion pesos.
So we have much work to do for 2025. We're not entirely happy with our revenue growth this year. And hopefully with the fact that most of our legacy revenue streams are really have hit us hard this year, but should attenuate, should reduce starting 2025.
As for San Miguel Corporation, it saw its nine-month bottom line climb 19% to 37.1 billion pesos. This thanks to an 11% revenue growth despite challenges such as typhoons and currency fluctuations. Ramon Ang's conglomerate also enjoyed improved profitability in its food, spirits, and infrastructure businesses, which offset lower refining margins in its fuel and oil units. And finally, Jollibee's third quarter bottom line attributable to parent jumped 15% to 2.8 billion pesos. This already reflects the impact of its $340 million acquisition of South Korea's Composed Coffee, which grew its international business 21%. Its local business saw steady growth thanks to Jollibee, Mang Inasal, and Chowking. Here are other earnings reports disclosed today.
Good for the U.S. That's how PLDT's chairman and CEO Manuel Pangilinan described former U.S. President Donald Trump's successful re-election bid. Pangilinan believes Trump will focus on strengthening the U.S. economy. He thinks the Philippines must implement measures to protect the peso as Trump threatens to slap hefty tariffs on Chinese goods.
So, the impact on the Philippines, on PLDT particularly, it's not too much because we most of our debts are in pesos, no? So we do have some debts, foreign debts, but only about 5%. In terms of the Philippine economy, there's got to be some interest rate cuts to stimulate the economy and as an antidote to what the U.S. might be doing. But we do have to rev up our exports.
The Philippine banking sector sees a profitable 9 months of 2024 despite loan losses. The BSP reports lenders saw a combined net profit of 290.6 billion pesos as of end September. That's up 6.4% from the same period in 2023. The increase was driven by growth in assets, deposits, and loans, with net interest income rising 14%. Combined losses on financial assets, however, grew more than fourfold to 76.20 billion pesos, while bad debt write-offs also rose to 2.3 billion. As of end September, total assets of Philippine banks are at 26.73 trillion pesos, which is 11.3% higher from last year.